Ain't nothing like getting home and seeing your package, because I know it's my wigs, at the damn front door. Lord, because Lord knows I've been tired of wearing this daggone raccoon's fur of a fucking wig on my head.
Go focus on this. Never them they gas. Never them.
Bliss, miss. Puts me hands on it. Got you all in the know. Sit there for me. Got a freak side who know. I'm here for it. I'm here for it. I'm here for it.
What's up, guys? So I'm currently leaving Quest Diagnostic. I had to get my blood drawn. I had to get my cholesterol checked, and I've been fasting. I haven't ate anything so far this morning. And so me and my boo, you'll see, I'm about to go meet up at Social House and get us some brunch, you know, some mimosas. Hopefully it ain't mimosa orange juice, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, about to do that right now. Like I said, I'm hungry. I don't even know what the hell I want to eat. I just know I want some food. So yeah. But yeah, it's work. Don't say my words.
That's her. Yep.
But yeah, it's work, man, trying to capture moments on Snapchat, Instagram, and then trying to do it regular on your phone.
And that's why I'm not doing it. I'm doing it because I want to.
Uh-huh.
So that when I look back, I can be like, yeah, there was a point in time where I stuck this out so I can practice signing, and I'm getting better at it. I get to use it more.
Yeah, this is good.
So we got the banana French toast, something has bananas, has the maple syrup. This syrup thick. Come a little whipped cream. She got bacon. I got sausage.
I made the better choice. Girls be like with a dang on camera and a phone, and then, you know?
Them be the two phone girls. Them the ones you gotta worry about.
I was testing when we had went to go see those animals.
The video or the pictures?
Both. Like everything.
They came out good.
I was struggling. I was like, hold up. Like I was trying to move, you know, both I passed real quick. I think the more I do it,
the better you'll be at it.
Yeah. Because, you know, like right now, like at first, before YouTube or whatever, it was just like, oh, let me get a video. Oh, let me get a, like, it was shit. But now it's like,
now you really got to get it.
Yeah.
I think instead of trying to capture the moment, maybe it'll help you get candid moments.
Okay.
Like it just happens naturally and you just happen to have your phone out, keep it ready.
Uh-huh.
So that when it comes up, people aren't waiting for it. They're not, okay, she's about to take a picture. All right, let's get ready. Uh-huh. And then it comes off a little fake. Not really, but you get what I'm saying. Where if it's a candid moment, it's naturally happening. Like it's a natural reaction.
Is it raining?
Why do people slow down when it's sprinkling?
I don't know.
Ground's not icy. It's a little rain. Little rain ain't never hurt nobody. But y'all want to slow down to 20 miles below the speed limit.
Niggas ain't got good tires. They ain't got no grip. That's all it is. That's all the fuck it is.
I'm gonna need y'all to get y'all's tires fixed. Replace them hoes, okay? Because it's people like me that want a hydroplane and get to my destination on time, okay? Stop slowing me down because you don't want to replace your bald ass tires. Tires be on some bald headed whole shit. I'm not here for none of that.
Hi guys. We just walking around.
I'm getting some quality time with my boo. because she finally got time for me.
Girl. No.
Y'all don't know. When y'all have positive energy in your life, you try so hard to keep it in your life, even when it's busy.
I ain't going no damn work. Shit.
She's busy for me, y'all.
We about to go into Tiff Treats. We about to see what's going on up in here. Fuck around and get some cookies or something. I don't know.
Nah,
I'm gonna
fuck around and really get some cookies.
10 years is a long time in this industry, and I have several photographers here with me that can attest to that. You know, you have some sacrifices, you lose some things, you gain some things, but for the most part, man, it's a lot of fun. You meet a lot of interesting people. And a lot of you guys here are more like family to me than just people that I have had the opportunity of shooting or networking with. You know, my photographer friends are more like my brothers. Amir, I call him my baby brother. Will Washington, y'all, is my mentor. And if y'all haven't met William, when I first started photography, we were at Jim Austin's event, which was... What's the gospel singer? What's her name? Will, help me out.
Peach.
What's that lady name?
A lot of people.
It's a gospel singer, but I can't think of her name right now. But anyway, he was there with Thick and Sexy.
But the what separates yourself is taking it to the next level. Anybody can push a button.
Exactly.
But then after that, it's the hours of editing, it's the hours of color correction, the hours of removing blemishes. That will separate you, make yourself a photographer. The eye. You know, so when me and Calvin started, I don't even know how we got on the thing about photography. It was just say, hey, well, Cal, you know, roll with me, man. I'm gonna go do a couple photo shoots. My first hotel to where he's at now. He's never lost the passion. Sometimes you get stagnant. I was telling Ben today, you get stagnant. Sometimes you're like, damn, I'm spinning my wheels. But then you sit back and you got people like you say, this model or this model said, man, I met Calvin. He put that fire in me. I got models that call me and say, Will, man, without working with you, you helped me. You helped me push me in. Help me take the difference.
So last night, networking event was cool. It was my very first time going to a networking event. And so I enjoyed it. I got to meet different people. I got to see like what it's like to go in there. One girl, she did, she specialize in like pure romance parties, which I've never been to, but that's what she does. Another girl, she specialized in mirrored vanities, and mirrors just the way she decorates them. And so she says she does really well doing it. Another woman in there, Larissa, she is a hairstylist, and Calvin, which is my photographer, he helped her launch her product line that's doing well. And then her friend is a media promoter. Like, she has her own media group, and what they do is they help brand people and get those people out there. And she just came back from the Grammys, and then she's about to get ready to go to the BT Awards. Like, that was pretty cool. And I was talking to Calvin. I met the lady that was next to. She's a model. She's like, she does print model for magazines or whatever. And just talking to her, it was like cool. She was telling me how she felt about being BBW and like being in the modeling industry. And she thought like, oh, people wouldn't want to work with me. But she said like, starting with Calvin and starting with Will, which is the guy that was talking, which is my photographer's best friend, working with them made her comfortable, and they boosted that confidence, which they do. Like, whenever you get the professional pictures done, like for me anyway, when I am working with Calvin, I'm extremely comfortable. I don't feel any type of way. I just know that his vision is great and my pictures always come out good. So yeah. And just talking to her, she was just saying the same thing, like how it is to work and how to, you know, work and also do your research. And I figured that much. And as I'm talking to them, you know, I explain to them, like, I mean, I work and then I'm trying to do YouTube or whatever. I'm trying to, you know. And I just learned that when it's your passion, it's not something that you just doing and that's it. It's like, you're going to invest your time, you're going to investigate not only your time just trying to perfect your craft, just trying to get everything together. And so they were like, they really, you know, was rooting for me. They was just like, yeah, we wish you the best. We want you to do this. Stick with it. If that's something that you really love. And it feels good to feel, you know, to hear that type of encouragement. That was just like, yeah, you know, always do research. Always, 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 always. And that's something I said I was going to do, or I do anyway. Invest at least 3 hours a night. I'm learning how to edit, learning how to add music, what songs I can't use, what songs are appropriate, what clips I can, what equipment, that type of thing, you know. And Calvin was telling me, like, he started in 2009. It takes time, and with time you grow. So that was always cool. And then William also too explained that, like, if it's a passion, you're gonna be after it like a crackhead. Like, it don't matter, you're gonna be out there trying to do it, and you're gonna give your all for it. So just stay focused, always do research and that type of thing. So it felt really good, and I'm glad I did go. But right now I'm currently laying in bed. I'm trying to edit these clips, and then eventually I'm going to go to church. And I'm working out, and that's the thing. I put my raccoon of a fur wig back on my head because I'm going to be working out today, and I don't want to mess up my new wigs. So, yeah, that's all I got for today. I need to put on some lashes. I just got up and did a little razzle dazzle, nothing major. But, yeah, so until next time, or, you know, just follow your heart, man. Follow your heart. Put effort into it. Put your time into it. And you'll be great. So, thank y'all for watching. Till next time.